Here we see the indigenous life forms of the planet Elanon. Remember the day we went snorkeling? Here are those fish that went everywhere. Dimitri, I'm already missing you so much. We're docking at the station soon. A bit of excitement at last, and I can't wait to actually get some real work done. I wish you were here with me. I'm a bit nervous. It's not like me at all, so when you get a chance, just tell me I'm being silly. Funny thing is, I'm convinced that warp space is altering my dreams. But I suppose it's just anxiety. That dreadful woman waiting to interview me, perhaps the moment I arrive. Anyway, that's enough of my paranoia. I'm happy, really. I love you. Don't get yourself killed and think of me every day, won't you? Record off.
Override. Delete message. Message deleted.
I have the authority to request whatever support I deem necessary, Commander. I need that ship. I need those troopers.
You must be expecting trouble on Arcadia.
We don't know what to expect, sir. We've had agents in just about all of Spin Ward Corp's other settlements, and they look legal.
Legal?
More so than most. And yet Spin Ward have been conspicuously successful, but it could be a run of luck. There's no Arcadia connection that we can detect.
So why do you need a troop ship to go visiting?
You know why, Commander. It's the Spin Ward planet we know the least about, and the only one where we lost an enforcement team. I suppose you haven't taken the trouble to find out what the fleet data net has?
Nothing. Colony founded 300 years ago, one of the first Spinwood settlements. No immigration or emigration records. No fleet survey, of course. All data courtesy of the Spinwood Corporation.
We have about the same.
You can have a troop ship. The Admiral Raystrick has been refitted. Keep your weapons in cry until you reach the system. Tell them there are Daleks on Arcadia to get them there.
Who in the blazes is that? Audience is over. Come back tomorrow, eh?
Francis.
Francis the scribe? Oh, you must come in. Come in. No, don't be so bashful, my dear fellow. You're not usually this way, if Christine is to be believed.
No.
Would you like a game of forfeits, eh?
Under certain circumstances, Your Highness. But perhaps not when there's a humble counselor waiting outside on the supplicant's bench.
What? A counselor? Here? Waiting to see me? Send him in. Send him in. And don't forget to close the door. Counselor, this is a most unexpected pleasure.
It is an honor to attend, Your Highness.
Has someone, has there been a bereavement of particular note?
By no means, Great Prince. I have come with an important message from the High Counselor at Landfall. But first, that overgrown apprentice scribe who brought me into your presence is...
An apprentice? Francis? I suppose he is still an apprentice. What of him?
The path of the scribe is ordained. It passes through Landfall. It must be nurtured in the correct manner.
Yes. Francis is highly gifted, Counselor.
All the more reason.
Master Percival relies on him.
Percival is a fool. Francis has been allowed to assist in Master's tasks. It is imperative that he leaves for Landfall immediately.
What tasks?
Important rituals.
I will send him to Landfall, of course. I'll give him the instructions myself. Now, about your important message.
Ah, quite. Men and Daleks have almost wiped each other out, and Landfall has discovered that a starship full of soldiers is heading towards this system, and each one carrying Dalek plague. We demand you arm your people, and when the starship arrives, there shall be no survivors.
Oh, you don't mean...
They are plague carriers. They must die.
Then it has happened. Violence has come at last to Arcadia.
Have I got two heads?
Yes, Matt.
So stop staring. I haven't asked for company.
A challenge. Don't mope, kid. You didn't get to go tomorrow, right? You good with your mouth?
What?
The booze talking. Ignore it. Listen, dog. We can't all get picked for this trip. Some you win, some you lose. I've seen you around, but I don't know you, do I?
No, you don't. And you won't get the chance to, unless you're going tomorrow.
Sure. No better tracker than Reynald Yesti.
You must be a clever guy.
Oh, yeah? And what are you doing this bunch with that pretty face?
Explosives. On secondment from IMC. And now, in special weapons.
You're kidding. Hey, I like a big bang myself.
I'll bet you do. And since you're on the ship, let's go.
Oh? Where to?
To my cabin. To see my etchings.
A what?
A very old joke. Come on, soldier. You deserve a good send-off.
Come on, Francis. The grass is dry. Come here.
It's no good, Christina. I don't think I can.
Francis!
I mean it! Stop. The prince is sending me to landfall.
Oh. Have they found out?
About us? I don't know.
My father used to hunt with the old prince. Edward wouldn't dare make a fuss about anything I wanted to do.
I don't think it's anything to do with us. Just me. Percival let me help him with the writing reports and letters, and those books I'm not supposed to see.
You and your secret books.
The volumes I gave you.
Safe at the bottom of my lion chest. Even Ally won't find them there.
That sister of yours is capable of anything. I don't suppose I'll ever be able to finish teaching the two of you how to read now.
But when you come back from landfall...
If I come back...
You'll come back.
If I come back, I'll be different. Thank you for everything, my lady.
Don't be silly. I won't let this happen. You'll see.
The counselors want me. There's nothing anyone can do about it. It's all in the books, Christina. You can read them for yourself. How old are you?
I'll be 30 soon. Not long to go, I suppose.
On other worlds, men and women live for 100 years at least.
Impossible.
It's true. It's in the books. That's one of the things the counselors don't tell us. What are they really up to? Why do people on Arcadia die so young? What are they doing to us? I don't know what to do.
Well, I do. We're going back home, and I'm going to have a few words with the prince.
You know, until now, I really hadn't decided about you.
But you're sure now, right?
Oh, I'm sure now.
What's happening?
Injector pad. Local anesthetic. But you won't be going anywhere for a few days.
You bitch!
Keep still. You won't feel a thing. And I mean that. Most sincerely.
What are you doing with that knife?
Don't panic, soldier. Just getting an ID implant. That's it. You become me, and I become you, Reynold Yesti. Only temporary, of course, until I get on board. Now I'm off to join the celebrations, and then Arcadia to kill the Daleks. Sleep well.
Doctor. Doctor! You know, most people take their shoes and socks off before they start paddling. I only mention it. Just some friendly advice. Oh, and another thing. The corridors keep changing. Left turns have become right and vice versa.
Penny! Who are you waving at? Too late. They've already gone.
And so have you, Doctor. Now look, about the corridors...
If I were you, Romana, I should stay in your room for a bit while these changes are going on. Why don't you configure the four-dimensional chess again? I'll give you another game.
Just forget it.
He cut a hole. I only wanted to look... The books. The secret books. Naughty. Not my fault. He cut a hole.
She's a daughter of the House of Delahaye. Why doesn't she snap out of it?
Don't shout, Gerald. You'll make her worse. She's to have complete rest while she's wearing the comfrey and henbane poultice. Help me pull the curtains. The room must be dark.
Dark? It was dark.
Yes, Elaine. The dark will do you good.
I heard someone. Come in. I hid in the wardrobe. Dark. It was dark. She wasn't happy. He cut a hole.
Four weeks in space and a stowaway? I never did expect this to be easy. Come in, please.
Hi, I'm Ace.
Agent Defries, trooper. You will salute when you see me, speak when you are spoken to, and address me as ma'am. You are in big trouble.
If you only knew, Agent Defries, how many times I've been told I'm in big trouble. What is it this time? Summary execution? Vivisection by cannibals? The death of 1,000 military tribunals?
Nothing so cruel. The other Orksies have spent the last month either in deep sleep or using up the booze and drugs I let them smuggle on board. You've been working out every day, using the ship's data net, and any time on the bridge has been spent getting friendly with Captain Toko and his crew.
What can I say? I like the stars.
We're in warp space, trooper.
But I know they're there. I like to know we're moving.
What's that, big stick?
This? Just a baseball bat, with some added pizzazz. Common where I come from.
Where exactly is home?
Here and there. I was in special weapons.
Not surprising. If we're lucky, we won't need you, of course.
But you'll feel better knowing I'm around. There's a lot of talk about your special weapon. The big secret in the weapons hold.
Not there. In the medical suite. Don't peek. It's a secret and it's guarded.
Oh, Agent Defries, that doesn't worry me in the slightest. See you on the bridge when we come out of warp.
I'll be there. But you'll be in your quarters, trooper.
Got an invitation from the captain, haven't I? And I wouldn't miss it for anything.
Right. Stone structure at the center. Dimitri, why wouldn't you stop me from coming? Breathe, Hoffman. Breathe.
I can feel your fear, you know.
She can't get you.
I have strengthened the net. Does my appearance alarm you?
What are you? How are you in my head?
I am Lacuna. I will tell you as much as I understand, but first, dear Britta, your record must stop. The physical imprint has been destroyed.
Out! Out of my head.
I cannot do that. You have been chosen to help our work. Pool requires you. Disobedience will not be tolerated. Not that you would disobey.
How are you doing this?
I am Lacuna, merely a maid servant, a sensory organ of the corporation.
Spinward is here? On Arcadia Station?
Oh, your intelligence has much to contribute. You are not ready to meet Pool. Let me show you something. Yes. That will do.
Where was I?
You were inside an analogy. A model, a paradigm. It is as close as you or I can experience to their reality. Was it not magnificent?
Yes. Yes, it really was. I see now. That was. That's the Spinward Corporation, isn't it?
Yes. And I believe that I can show them everything about you. You will be with me at every moment, and I with you. You are ready to serve the corporation.
So tell me. I'm completely healthy, aren't I?
Well, about that. Yes and no. At the very least, Defries will be interested to know that every cell in your body is infected with some sort of virus.
So, how long have I got? And should I leave my body to science?
I didn't say you were ill. The virus is benign. Have you noticed any unusual symptoms recently?
Doctor, what have you done to me?
What do you mean? This is simply a diagnostic test.
Oh no, not you. A different doctor.
The virus seems to be looking after your cells and is incredibly pervasive, yet nonspecific. If I could speak with this doctor, or maybe if I had a sample?
Oh, that wouldn't be possible. Anyway, those rooms back there.
Oh no, you aren't getting back there. It's cryogenics, and an alarm sounds if anyone tries to enter without the code.
Not even for a bit of me.
Not that I wouldn't, I see. Sorry. A small blood sample may allow me to look the other way, for a moment.
Of course.
Then this'll only take a moment. You have 5 minutes.
I'll be back in 4. Ah, here we go. Defries' weapon, I presume. Computer, who is this?
Human. Ma'am.
Injuries?
Physically intact.
Name?
Absalom Dak, version 3. Dalek killer number erased.
So that's what she's bringing to Arcadia. How much longer in cryo?
4 days, 15 hours, 57 minutes.
Any problems with the auto-resuscitation?
Auto-resuscitation selected with 2% error probability.
Reset for 4 days. Seek interview with Trooper Ace.
Noted.
It's been 4 minutes!
On my way!
Time travel. Okay, Absalom Dak. Time to see how you died.
Hello, I'm the Doctor and this is my friend Ace. Hello, I'm the Doctor and this is my friend Ace!
I might have guessed. Very Alice in Wonderland, Doctor.
Yes? Who are you?
I know, it's been a long time, Professor, but do me a favour.
Professor? Yes, there was a professor.
It's me. Ace. You know, as in, I'm the Doctor, and this is my friend Ace.
You're...
Something's happened. What have you gone and done to yourself this time?
You're Ace!
Yes. Are we in the TARDIS?
TARDIS? Yes. Yes, I think I remember the word TARDIS. Memories. They're all in here, you know. Somewhere, Ace. Ace. Yes, that's you, of course. Mel, Miss Clark, Flip, Mila, Evelyn, Perry, Spectrox, nasty stuff. Nailed by the mouth, I'd say. Daleks. Ah, yes, and Davros. Earth, London, twice, no, 3 times. Susan. Well, that's enough of that. They're all in there, anyway. Ah, yes, it's all here. Oh, temple engineering. You know, I've never seen it quite like that before. It's like being away from home, and then coming back and seeing your furniture as if for the first time. I always knew it was big, of course, but it's so symmetrical. Do you know what I mean?
No. Look, are you better now, or not?
I think so. There are grey areas. Block transfer computations, for instance. And something to do with chameleon circuits, whatever they are.
Don't worry, Doctor. It can't be any greyer than it used to be.
Ask me a question.
A question?
Yes. Something really challenging. N-dimensional geometries, that sort of thing.
How long is a piece of string?
That's a tricky one. Infinite regression mathematics was never one of my strong subjects. Well, it depends. How long was the original string of which the piece in question is a piece?
All right. You're definitely back to your old self. Just spare me the Time Lord jokes, okay?
Oh, don't be so miserable, Ace. It's not every day you get the chance to restore an entire mind. Certainly not a mind as full as mine. It's like visiting a museum. It's going up and down staircases, opening cupboards full of information, throwing open doors that lead to entire storerooms of data.
Talking of throwing open the doors, Doctor, have you noticed there aren't any? In this room, I mean. Are you a prisoner?
Well, I don't know. Can't remember. Where am I?
You're asking me. It looks like the TARDIS. The walls aren't typical, no round things, but they're made of the same stuff. Wasn't there a room you had to ditch? A useful room that insulated you from everything when one of your regenerations went wrong?
Nissa, Tegan, help push me in a chair.
A zero room, that's what you called it.
Yes, Ace, how could I ever thank you? I did it, the plan worked. I knew it would, of course, if only I could stop myself thinking about it.
Typical. Now, would you like to tell me about it?
Of course I will, Ace. Where would you like me to start?
How am I supposed to know? You never used to tell me what was going on.
Oh, right.
And don't give me that. You were being even more stroppy than normal. I don't know what was wrong with you. Everything should have been okay. You remember the TARDIS was destroyed? And then there was that business in Turkey and New York and all that. And then we went off to that Tiananog place and got the stuff to finish fixing the TARDIS. After that, everything should have been fine.
And that's precisely when something else went wrong.
You're not kidding. After that, you went noping around the Yorkshire Moors. You know, I made sure the TARDIS didn't have a gas oven just in case you thought of putting your head in it. I got you out of that mess at the radio telescope. And did I get any thanks? No. I got my heart broken instead. And then...
There's more.
And then you hardly spoke to me at all on Heaven. And I met Jan. And you let him die.
And that's when you left me. Yes, I remember. But I had to do it, Ace. Believe me. It was all part of the plan.
What plan?
You see, the TARDIS was contaminated. There was an impurity in the organic matter I used to refuel the link with the Eye of Harmony. The protoplasm from Tiananog must have contained a small fragment of one of Goimney's experiments. Ace, are you listening? It infected the TARDIS, you see. And that meant it was in my mind, too. I couldn't make any conscious plans to get rid of it, because it always knew everything I knew. You must understand how serious the situation was. I've had to shut down the TARDIS and myself. Ace!
What about me, Doctor? I was so young in those days. You needed me, so you stopped me staying with Robin. You let Jan die, and then you made me leave the TARDIS. I thought I was making the decision, but you wanted me out, so I went!
You haven't changed, Ace. It wasn't a game. I made mistakes recently. People have died, and now, for the first time since I repaired the link, I am free of the presence that has been riding inside me. Is it any wonder I was bad-tempered? And all you can do is blame me for your boyfriend problems!
I... Never mind. It was all a long time ago.
Was it?
Two. Probably 3 Earth years, I guess.
Surely not. It doesn't seem as long as that.
This is a time machine, Professor. It can be 5 minutes for you, 50 years for me, or the other way around.
But I sent for you to react as soon as I entered the Zero Room. You know, Ace, I feel as though I'm being manipulated again.
That's rich. Coming from you. What the hell?
Ace, move away from the wall!